Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Gene, its nature, expression and regulation. In that, we are studying topic, the modern concept of gene. We all have different characteristics. For example, you'll have some characteristics of your father and some of your mother. How does that happen? It is due to genes which are present on DNA. Today we'll be studying about genes. Genes. Suppose your father is having curly hairs and your mother has straight hairs. There are chances that you might get curly hairs or you might get straight hairs. Now this chance is dependent upon which gene of your parent is dominant and which is recessive. Yes, today we'll be studying about genes, and these genes decide your character or your traits. For example, the color of your skin, the shape of your hairs, the color of your eyes, the way you talk, all such things are determined by genes which are present on DNA. Remember, DNA is your genetic material, and that double-stranded DNA consists of a pair of genes for a particular trait or character. This trait or character could be anything. Could be your weight, could be your height, the way you speak, the color of your hair, the color of your skin, etc. Now genes basically are nothing but basic physical functions or unit of heredity. For example, one set of gene you get it from your father and one set of gene you get it from your mother. So if genes are present in pairs, one of them from a pair is from father and another one is from the mother. That is why genes are called as hereditary material. In the modern concept of gene, genes are termed as cistron or cistron molecules. The modern concept of gene says that for one cistron, there is one polypeptide. Now, what is this one cistron and one polypeptide? We all know that on the DNA strand, there are genes which are present in pairs, and these genes will help or will code for amino acid, which is nothing but present on mRNA strand. Now mRNA will have nucleotides, or you can say bases, exposed on it, which will help in the formation of proteins, or in some language you can say in the formation of various traits. So for example, if the color of your skin has to be decided, whether it will be whitish, brownish, wheatish, or on the darker side, then you will have a gene that will be coding for this gene, and this will be nothing but present on your DNA, which will go via the process of transcription and then translation. Transcription is RNA synthesis and translation is that protein synthesis which decide your gene color. Now genes can sometimes be of two types. One is the recon type and another one is the mutant type. Modern concept of gene. We all know that genes are basic unit of heredity. The way you look is decided by pairs of genes present on deoxyribose nucleic acid. Now the present concept or the present day concept of gene says that gene is nothing but unit of function which is known as cistrons. The simple theory is that one cistron is related or correlated to one polypeptide, means one cistron will help the formation of one protein or one trait. Now genes can be of two types, or there are two variations which genes can show. The one variation is of recon type. Now, this type are nothing but smallest unit of DNA that are capable of undergoing crossing over. When I say crossing over, it means mixing over. But when I talk about mutants, now these genes can undergo mutation. When I say mutation, it is nothing but change in nucleotide sequence. If the normal nucleotide sequence, that is ATGC or whatever is the base pairing, not followed, then there are chances that genes would become mutated. Now, not necessarily that every mutation of a gene is a positive change. Some mutations are also negative, or they can have disorders. Whenever there is mutation undergoing for a gene, that those genes can be termed as mutants. In this diagram, what is shown is how from a DNA, that is the gene which is present on the DNA, the journey goes to the production of a polypeptide chain, that is for the production of a trait. Now, we all know that DNA is double-stranded, helical, or genetic material. On each strand of DNA, there are pair of genes present, and this pair of genes denote a character or a trait. One pair we get it from our father, and another pair we get it from our mother. Now, these genes basically help to code for mRNA. mRNA is single-stranded. It has codons. Now, with the help of anticodons present on tRNA, polypeptide chain or protein is formed, and ribosomes take part. Basically, the process of transcription and translation. So genes, in simple language, genes are made up of DNA, you can say, that provide instructions to make proteins, or genes are present on DNA that help to make protein molecules, or which determine your traits. Students, today in this part of the chapter, we studied about genes, who define your character, the way you look, and how genes come. Some sets, one set is from your parent, that is from your father, and another set is from your mother. And whichever gene is dominant or strong, that character you'll have. And whichever is less strong, that character you won't have. I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.